if you're talking about hugging, then certainly that should be okay. You talk about the occasional kiss, then it's probably up to the headmaster of the school to decide.
Maybe some forms of PDA, yeah?
A kiss on the cheek or the lips, yeah, to say goodbye or hello, yeah, then that's suitable.
I think it's good. So at school, yeah, we're not allowed to kiss. We can hold hands and hug and no one will mind, but you can't kiss.
Everyone is capable of love from when they're born. You shouldn't be restricting a kid's ability to express that, because then they grow up and they feel like it's weird, or they don't really feel comfortable interacting with other people.
I think hugging should be allowed, because if your best friend gets an A on her test and you want to show her that, you know, you're excited for her, you give her a hug. And that is not something that should be taken away.
No, I don't think it should be banned.
I look at my daughters at a very young age, I'm afraid.
High school, yeah, like maybe primary school is a little bit too young.
40 and 50, but you only speak, kiss without sex.
I think from 15 to 16.
15, I'd say, is normal.
I would say around 14.
There was more hugging and kissing when I was in the hugging and kissing age.
I think English people kiss more. I have a Chinese boyfriend and maybe in public he is very shy, I think.
We show love for people. No, love with friends, love with other people, love with girl, love with men, love everything.
In France and England, yeah, you do see people kissing.
There's definitely a great sense of PDA in my home country.
Once the affection borders on public intercourse, then it's certainly a borderline that has been exceeded.
Sometimes a little shocking, but yeah, not really offended.
Yeah, you don't know where to look, but otherwise it doesn't bother me.
This is a normal.
Okay.
Personally, I like to see people expressing themselves freely. We treat these little things that we do every day on a daily basis. Everyone does them.
Yeah.
But when we see it, we get bothered by it. We just gotta look at ourselves before like looking at everyone else and judging everyone else.
Look away. It's like, okay, they're doing their thing.
I'm fine. I don't really mind it.
Well, I'm totally fine with it as long as it's not overdone.
Why not? After all, it's my wife.
No, but I'm affectionate in public. I don't like personally, but I don't mind it.
Again, if it's like a hug or a kiss, I like, but I would never go over the top in public.
If I love my girl, I walk with her, she go to the street, go to the shopping. If I want kiss, not kiss too much, too many minutes. So one kiss, it's a normal for me.
It should just be seen as normal. There's like such a weird like taboo around like PDA, and I think it's kind of stupid. Like, we're humans and we're meant to do these things, so we should just embrace it.
In our Mexican culture, people are not afraid to show emotion. And that's part of the Latin personality and character that defines not only Mexico, but Latin America.
Chinese culture will be more traditional. That means what is acceptable in Germany is not necessarily acceptable in China.
I see women, two hands.
Hold hands.
Yes, and walking. This one, I don't know, what is this? This is a friendly? Or something else. In Serbia, this is a notar.
In the US, they're more open about PDA, and here, it's like little to none.
Some people are more reserved. They don't want to talk to people. They don't open up to people, just in terms of like talking. So
I think that China is like, they're warming up to PDA, because I start to see it more and more, and it surprises me.
I don't see a lot of Chinese people holding hands or showing a lot of emotion towards each other. That's quite a stark difference in between Mexico and China.
My first kiss, I think, 7 years.
7 years.
When I go to before primary school, I have nine girls in my.
Nine girls.
Yes, 7 years. 7 years. Now, in my country, I have 10 girls.
Ten
and one woman. Yes.